Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Welcome again to another wonderful episode of our special program, Grace for Greener Pasture. Today is the 5th of October, 2020. Shall we pray? Father, I want to bless you. I want to appreciate you because you are the mighty God. You are the great deliverer. I want to thank you for supporting us. Thank you, Lord, for the first 4 episodes and today. As we go into this wonderful day, this week, that they let heaven open upon us in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for what you have done. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Good morning again, and welcome to this continual episode of our program that we started last week. The topic was the 7 obstacles to abundant success. And we spoke about the unteachable spirit, the unpaid vows, and the unforgiving offenses. We said these are one of the three out of the 7 reasons why people don't have abundant success. And we specifically ended that section of last week Monday, stating that forgiveness is not a suggestion, but a requirement. For you to have abundant success, you must take forgiveness as a requirement, not a suggestion. And today, we'll be moving to obstacle number 4, after we spoke about unteachable spirit, unpaid vows, and unforgiving offenses. Number 4 obstacle, why Christians, why believers, why professionals don't have abundant success. We'll talk about unwise association. Unwise association. The wisest man after the Lord Jesus Christ that came to this world was Solomon. And Solomon said in Proverbs chapter 13, verse 20, he said, "He that walketh with wise men shall be wise, but a companion of fool shall be destroyed." In fact, Apostle Paul in the New Testament, 1 Corinthians 15, verse 33, 1 Corinthians 15, verse 33, he says, "Evil communication corrupt good manners." Evil communications corrupt good manners. Brethren, as a professional, as a career person, as an entrepreneur, as a consultant, you must understand that unwise friendship and association have destroyed the potentials and abilities of multiplied thousands of could-be winners. That means people that should have won, people that should have been victorious, because they kept unwise friendship, they kept unwise association, they have destroyed their potential. Therefore, brethren, take it as a very important issue in this week. Don't follow unwise friendship. Don't go with unwise association, because they will destroy your potential. They will bury your abilities, and they would not make you to be an abundant winner, which would have been if, because you would have become an abundant success. Praise the Lord. So whoever cannot increase you will eventually decrease you. Don't work with people that will decrease you. Work with winners. An eagle works with an eagle. If you put an eaglet and a chick together, as time goes by, an eagle will discover that he is not a chick. Once he sees an eagle flying, he will know that he has potential. Work with people who will not bury your potential, who will not bury your abilities. In fact, your ability to disconnect from unqualified person who abuse and misuse your life is an invaluable decision you need to take this week. People that are unqualified, who abuse or misuse your life, you must disconnect from them. How do I know this? In fact, if you look at the story and the behavior pattern of Jesus Christ, Jesus allowed only 2 kind of people to absorb his time, to take his time. He did not allow time wasters to ruin his ministry. The first set of people Jesus accepted to himself were people who ministered to him. And second, were those who received his ministry that he shared. He knew that the Pharisee does not deserve his time because they abuse it. So therefore, this week, when someone does not value your time, brethren, I can tell you they will not value your wisdom. People who don't value your time, they will not value your wisdom. So this week, go in that spirit to reevaluate your life and reevaluate your friendship. Reevaluate your friendship. If you reevaluate your friendship, then certainly this week, you will overcome this obstacle of unwise association. Do not allow your dreams to be eroded. Do not allow your goals to be limited. Because relationship with those who laugh at your pursuit of accomplishment will kill your goals, will kill your dreams, and they will kill your ability to succeed in life. So disconnect from people. Disconnect from people who are laughing at you, who are not supporting your goal. Disconnect from them. Stop managing them. Stop telling them, okay, I will be with you again tomorrow. Those who want to erode your dreams, don't connect with them. Those who want to limit your goal because you are related to them, disconnect from them. David, God disconnected David from his brother, Joseph. God disconnected Joseph from his brethren. Why? Because they will kill his dream. And while they thought they put Joseph in the pit, God actually separated them from him so that his dream can be realized and they will come and bow to the result of his dream. I decree in the name of Jesus this week, as we move ahead, all those who want to keep you in the pit, who want to limit your dreams, who want to limit your goals, God will disconnect them from you so that you can go and conquer in your Egypt and become a dream realizer in the name of Jesus. So this week, how do you recognize your enemies and opposition? Four ways for you to recognize your enemies and opposition. Number one, those who are more critical than they are complimentary or encouraging. Those who criticize you more, they criticize you deeply, and they don't compliment you or encourage you, then you begin to suspect them that they are your enemies and not your friends. Number two, those who belittle you and laugh at your God-given dreams and goals. Those who look at your goals and your dreams and they belittle them and laugh at your God-given dreams and goals, then watch out for them. They are your enemies and they are your opposition. Number three, those who embarrass and humiliate you at any opportunity. They embarrass and humiliate you at any opportunity, then they are not your friends. They are your opposition and your enemies. Number four, those who siphon your energy and time through useless stuff. They take away your time. Maybe you have people like that on your WhatsApp, on your Instagram, on your any form of social media handle. They take away your time conversing with you on useless talk, unproductive talk, unproductive exercise, unproductive consultation, unproductive ideology. Those are your enemies. They are not your friends. Please, this week, as you go, I want to inform you, how do you recognize wise association? Number one, how do you recognize wise association? Number one, those who speak words that build your faith and confidence. Anyone that tells you are trying, you are doing better, then they are good association with you. For they speak good word that build your faith and confidence, then their wise association move closer. Number two, those who see the validity and beauty of your God-given dreams and goals. They see the validity and beauty of God's giving dreams and goals. Then their wise association, stay with them. Number three, how do you recognize wise association? Those who get excited about your potential. When they see your potential, they see you becoming bigger. They see you becoming wider. They see you becoming a better individual. They are the wise association. They are not envious of your potential. They don't want to draw you down. They don't want to kill your dreams. They don't want to limit your goals. then their wise association, stay with them. Number four, those who remind you of your special gifts and abilities. There are some people, they don't want to remind you. Once you make a mistake, they capitalize on it so that you can be demoted. Be careful. They are not wise association. But anyone who reminds you of your special gifts and tell you you have potential to do more, you can do better, you can get better, you can bring results, you can do this, you can be a greater entrepreneur, then they are the wise association you should get glued to. So those who remind you of your special gifts and abilities, they are the wise association. So this week, as I conclude, it is up to you to choose the level of mentality you want to live on. So this week, the level of mentality you want to live on, whether you want to go with the wise association, whether you want to stay with the enemy and your opposition, is now left for you. The barometer of your mentality is now in your hands. Which direction do you want to go? You want to stay with the wise, like King Solomon said, or you want to stay with the foolish association? My prayer this week is that you will make the right decision this week in the name of Jesus. So if in this week you should be cautious. You should look critically. If you will give your time to those unworthy of it, those who are not worthy of your time, who are not worthy to exercise, to know about your potential, so that you will stop complaining in the future while you give your time to those kind of people. So, because if you give your time to people who don't deserve it, then you don't have a reason to complain. So, your level of mentality this week will determine how far you will go. And I pray you will take good decision on that project, on that business deal, on that consulting work, in that presentation, in your office, even in the interview. You will be better than the best in the name of Jesus. So don't give people the opportunity this week to abuse you. Because in the first place, if you give people the opportunity to abuse you, you gave them the opportunity in the first place. So become critically selective of people you associate with. Don't pick ordinary people. Daniel, he picked Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. David, he picked Jonathan. He did not pick friends anyhow. He did not associate anyhow. So become more selective this week because you are a champion. A champion does not be a friend of someone who does not want to succeed. Become selective. Overall, as you go in this week, in a new wave, in a new realm, in a new wavelength, remember that the same time you wasted on loser is that same time you would have invested with winners. You have no business with losers. So because the same time you invested in losers is the same time you would have invested in winners. You are an eagle, so invest in evil likes. You're a champion, invest in your time with potential champions. Don't invest your time with people who have no idea, who have no plan, who have no dream, who are not going anywhere. Stop saying it is break time. I can while away my time with people who have no time. No. Invest your time with people who will be winners like you. Birds of the same feather. The Englishman says, they flock together. So as youth and young adults, I'm encouraging you this week, pick the right association. Stop following unwise association. Don't be restricted. Don't create a barrier towards your abundant success. And my prayer this week is that as you go, you will fly, you will go beyond the storm, you will be a champion. Every unwise association, God will disconnect you from them. And the Lord will give you victory. You will come with testimony. From this Monday, 5th of October, 2020, to the end of the week, you will only meet winners like you. And you will invest your time quality, and God will give you pleasant surprises. God bless you. Have a wonderful week. Maranatha. Amen.